Welcome to St. John's, everyone. It is wonderful to have all of you. Lots of people today. Thank you so much. We are celebrating the 15th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We especially welcome all those who are visiting with us. At this Mass, we remember in a special way Benjamin Munson. Benjamin Munson. Would you please stand and give a sign of welcome to those around you? Our opening hymn is number 564, called Come, Ye Thankful People, Come.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, welcome to this celebration of our Mass for 15th Sunday in Ordinary Time. As we always do, during these Masses that are also posted online and watched by many of our parishioners and people from our area and from faraway places, we want to be united, especially during this Mass, with all of you who are out there, members of our community, connected through prayer, through sacrifices of your lives, and through all you do for our parish and for all the people, especially your loved ones. So as we begin this Mass, let us once again place ourselves in the presence of our loving and eternal God, the one who guides us, the one who sustains us, the one who protects us, and the one who brought us here once again to his altar to listen to his word and to be fed by the great gift of his very body.
Lord Jesus, you teach us the way to salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you show seeds of hope across the world. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you cultivate rich soil in the kingdom of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us into everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, heavenly King, O God,
Almighty Father, Heart and Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father.
You take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
and have mercy on us.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth
peace to people of goodwill. Amen,
amen, amen.
Let us pray. O God, you show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path. Give all who, for the faith they profess, are counted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and strive after all that does it honor, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there, till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
The psalm response today is called, "The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest."
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. You care for the earth, give it water. You fill it with riches. Your river in heaven brims over to provide its grain. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. And thus you will provide the earth. You drench its furrows. You level it, soften it with flush showers. You bless its growth. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. You crown the earth with your goodness. abundance flows in your steps. In the pastures of the wilderness it flows, the seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest. The hills are girded with joy, the meadows covered with flocks, the valleys are decked with wheat. They shout for joy, yes, they sing. The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, but not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be sent free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even until now, and not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Matthew. On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. Such large crowds gathered around him, and he got into a boat and sat down, and the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, "A sower went out to sow. As he sowed, some seeds fell on a path. The birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground where it had little soil. It sprang up at once because the soil was not deep, and when the sun rose, it was scorched, and with it withered for lack of roots. Some seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seeds fell on rich soil and produced fruit, 100 or 60 or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you.
Jesus was one of the greatest teachers of all times, obviously the best. But as any teacher knows, there is nothing more frustrating than trying to teach students who do not fully comprehend what you are saying. At the start of today's gospel, you could almost hear Jesus saying to himself, "They don't get it. They just don't get it." Thus, he quotes Isaiah from the longer version of today's gospel. "You shall indeed hear, but not understand. You shall indeed look, but never see." And of course, these words are meant for us as our world as well. Despite many centuries of preaching the gospel, we live in a world that still does not get it. Jesus had excellent understanding of human nature. He knew the human condition. He knew that a frontal assault on disbelief would not work. And so he used the teaching device of telling a story. He knows that people love a good story, especially one that has a hook in it to hold the attention and to keep the mind pondering the real meaning of the story. The Gospels are filled with parables. This was Jesus' favorite method of teaching. Among the rabbis at Jesus' time, there was an attitude almost of reverence towards the parable. So when Jesus adopted this method of teaching, he was following a tradition back then. But why teach in parables? Once there was a famous rabbi who loved to illustrate a truth by means of a story. One day, his students asked him why he adopted such an approach. He replied, "The best way to answer all your questions is through a story." So he continued, "There was a time when truth went around naked and unadorned, but the people shied away from him and gave him no welcome. So truth wandered throughout the land, rejected and unwanted. One day, very dejected, he met Story, strolling along happily, dressed in a multicolored robe. Truth, he said, "Why are you so sad?" "I am sad because I am so old and ugly that everyone avoids me," Truth replied. "Nonsense," laughed Story. "That is not why people avoid you. Here, borrow my robe and see what happens." So Truth donned the Story's multicolored robe, and lo and behold, everywhere he went, he was welcomed. And the rabbi concluded, "The fact is, people are unable to face the naked truth. They much prefer the truth disguised. Sometimes the truth can be so painful that we are not able to take it straight on. We have to dress it up. We have to decorate it. A story makes a bit of truth more tolerable. A parable has another great advantage. Just as the candle can help a searcher find that gold coin or a priceless pearl in the fields, so too can a short parable contain a great truth and enable us to get to that heart of that truth. What is Jesus saying to us in his short parable of the sower? The word of God is to the human heart what a seed is to the earth. Just as soil is barren without seed, so our lives are barren without the word of God. The Word of God is a pure and lasting font of spiritual life. Through His Word, God is continually calling us to a better and more fruitful life. Happy are those who make the voice of God the most important voice in their lives. God doesn't speak to us like a dictator to His subjects. He speaks to us as a caring father speaks to his children. His word is as gentle, as weak, and as defenseless as a seed that falls into the soil. Yet that word is more effective than the word of the most powerful dictator. It can change people's hearts. God doesn't just speak to us in the Holy Scriptures. He also speaks to us through the events of our lives. But it is the word of Scripture that helps us to interpret what God is saying to us in those special events. We will not be judged by results, but only by the efforts we have made. As Van Gogh once said, "Life is only a kind of seeding time. The harvest is not yet here."
Let us now all profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Just as the rain comes down to make the earth fertile and fruitful, let us ask for God's gifts to be showered upon us as we bring our prayers to him, our loving and eternal God.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For all bishops, priests, and deacons, may the grace of God nourish them in mind, body, and spirit as they preach the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who serve in public office, may the Lord grant them hearts of justice and compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those burdened with any manner of suffering, may God renew in them a hope that brings consolation and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this community, that our hearts may welcome the word of God and be fertile soil for when the seed will produce an abundant harvest of faith and charity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, that they find comfort and caring of loved ones and healing through the hand of God, especially Gina Morrow and Amy Kantowitz. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may God welcome them to eternal rest in heaven, especially Anne Marie Remol and Irma Ty Linda. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Benjamin Munson, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our Creator, bless the earth, make and keep it fertile and fruitful, and bless us all so we continue to grow in faith, hope, and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The hymn for offertory is number 507, number 507, called I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light. Number 507.
I want to walk as a child of the light. I want to follow Jesus. God set the stars to give light to the world. The star of my life is Jesus. In him there is no darkness at all. The night and the day are both alike. The Lamb is the light of the city of God. Shine in my heart, Lord Jesus. I want to see the brightness of God. I want to look at Jesus. Clear sun of righteousness, shine on my path, and show me the way to the Father. In him there is no darkness at all. The night and the day are both alike. The Lamb is the light of the city of God. Shine in my heart, O Jesus.
Pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you lay the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You form man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, to Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Of all holiness, make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and a chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Benjamin Munson, and all the members of the Benjamin's family have gone before us, as well as all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with blessed apostles, with Saint John the Baptist and all the saints, I praise you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Now let us pray to our Heavenly Father in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Lord.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
The first communion song today will be "Open My Eyes, Lord, That We practiced right before Mass began tonight.
Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to see your face. Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to see.
Open my ears.
Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear your voice. Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear.
Open my heart, Lord.
Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love like you. Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love. And the first shall be last, and our eyes are opened, and we'll hear like never before. And we'll speak in new ways, and we'll see God's face in places we've never known. Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to see your face. Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to
Second Communion hymn can be found in the green hymnal number 707, called Guide My Feet, number 707.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Before the final blessing, just first of all, a word of thank you, and then one simple announcement. And thank you is to each and every one of you, to many parishioners who in any way express your concern about how we are doing here at St. John's in light of all the heavy rains that we have had. As you can imagine, the brook is coming up and then descending over and over again. We got lucky a few times when the brook came all the way to the back parking lot area and then rescended. But it is certainly an issue that I will not give up on. The situation regarding Pascack Brook is very serious. The flooding in the area, a potential danger to our parish and to our properties, always serious. And we had to deal with one urgent situation where one of the big, big trees on the property of one of our neighbors here on the west side collapsed in the middle of the week and came down to the brook on the property of St. John the Baptist. It took DPW of Hillsdale 2 days or 3 days to get here, but we got it partially cleared. But the problem is that almost every big tree along the brook now has a root structure seriously compromised. So I will push and I will talk and I will be talking once again with the authorities here in Hillsdale and with all those who are in any way competent, because this is a very serious issue for all of us. So thank you for all of your concern and your expressions of love and concern about how we are doing, and we'll do everything we can to protect our parish and to protect our property in this situation. And the second announcement is regarding a wonderful group, and that is the voluntary ambulance squad here in Hillsdale, a wonderful group of men and women who serve the entire community day in and day out. Many of our, especially elderly, had a privilege to receive their kindness and their service. And we have one table here this today and one at every Mass throughout this entire Sunday of them selling their 50-50 raffle tickets. That's for us an opportunity to support the Hillsdale Voluntary Ambulance Squad. And because they are there in the main lobby, I would ask you if you can walk to the back of the church. They are there, and if you can support them in any way, I will be very, very grateful. And once again, thank you to all those volunteers who work so tirelessly to serve our community and to serve in all the emergencies that we have here in Hillsdale. The Lord be with you.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
May your people receive your holy blessing, O Lord, we pray, and by that gift turn away from all that would harm them and obtain what they desire. And may Almighty God bless you and keep you always in his loving care, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and each other.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you all of you for singing tonight. The final song is number 735 in the Gather Hymnal called They'll Know We Are Christians by Our Love. Number 735.
We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray that our unity may one day be restored. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know.
First verse again.
We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray that our unity may one day be restored. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know.